Hi, this is a forScore tutorial on how to use the Rearrange feature to navigate codas, repeats, and cuts in your score. The Rearrange feature allows you to cut, copy, paste, and rearrange pages within your score. Now there's another feature called links, which also is useful for navigating codas, repeats, and cuts. And the difference between the two is that while links is easier to set up, you do need to have a hand free in order to tap the screen and turn the page. Whereas with the Rearrange feature, it takes a little more time to set up your score, but once you have the pages set up in the right order, then you can either use your hand to tap the screen and turn the pages, or you can use a page turning pedal, such as the kind that are sold by AirTurn and PageFlip, to turn the page in your score. So if you're a musician who plays an instrument where you would prefer to use a foot pedal to turn the page and you don't have hands free, then this might be a method that's preferable for you. Now here's an example of a score that's a little bit tricky to navigate. It's got a couple of repeated sections, each with a first and second ending, as well as a DSL coda. And if I flip through the score, you can see where I've highlighted some of these markings. By going through the score, I've determined the sequence of pages I will be viewing during performance. As you can see, there will be some repeated pages as well as some skipped pages. Now let's go back to forScore and use the Rearrange tool to put the pages in this order. To open the Rearrange tool, tap the center of the score to bring up the menu bar, then tap the toolbox, and then under Edit the Score, tap on Rearrange. This brings up a screen that shows all of the pages of the score as thumbnails along with the page number indicated in gray. To change the order of a page, tap on the page that you want to move and hold it, and then drag and release it to the position where you'd like the page to go. To make a copy of a page, tap and hold the page, and then drag and release it on top of this box with a plus sign on it. And to delete the page, tap on the X in the top left corner. You can also rotate pages by tapping on the page with two fingers and then swiveling your fingers clockwise or counterclockwise, depending on which way you want to rotate it. It's taking me a few tries to do that, but that should give you an idea. To rotate all of the pages in the score, use the arrow buttons on the top center of the toolbar to rotate them either clockwise or counterclockwise. Once you've completed your changes, you can use the Save or Save As buttons in the top right to save the score and rearrange in the order that you'd like it. I highly recommend that you use the Save As button so that in case you've made any mistake, you'll still have the original score to go back to. However, if you want to cancel all of your changes and start from scratch, you can either use the Reset button on the top left to reset the score back to the order and number of pages that it was originally, or just press the cancel to cancel out of the rearrange operation entirely. If at any time you need a reminder of how to do any of these rearrange operations, just tap on the I on the bottom right corner of the screen, and that'll bring up the online help for the rearrange feature. Now I'm going to go ahead and rearrange and copy the pages in the page sequence that I'd like to perform. I finished arranging the pages of my score in the order that I want them, and now I'm going to tap Save As in the top right corner to save my score. And I'm going to name it a little bit differently than my original, just so that I know that it's the rearranged version. And now I've got my rearranged version of the score in front of me. You can see in the title bar, the original score was 10 pages, and now I have 19 because I made copies and put them in a different order. And if I flip through, you can see that it's kept the markings that I've used with the annotation tool. But now I have the pages in the new order. Your score is now ready to go if you want to use simple page turns, either by tapping or by using a Bluetooth pedal to navigate the piece from beginning to end. Now I'm going to show you another trick that's useful when you're rearranging your score. Suppose, for example, that you're preparing the score for a pianist who's going to sight read it, and you don't want to include any confusing or distracting extra markings or music in the score. What you can do is use forScore's annotation tool to remove any extra music or markings that are left once you've copied and rearranged the pages in your score. So for example, on this page, this is the place where I'm going to want to go to the first ending, and since I've already made another copy of this page that has the second ending, I don't really need the music for the second ending on this page. So I can bring up the annotation toolbar, and then go to draw, and then select the white marker. And then I can actually erase some of the extraneous information on the score. So I might just remove this second ending entirely. So I'll increase the size of the white marker to make that a little bit faster. So I can go like that. And I can even do things like remove the first ending marker and maybe the repeat sign too, so that's not too much of a source of confusion. I'm doing a sloppy job here, but you should get the idea that you can remove some of the extra information, and if you need to clean this up a little bit or fix it, or you want to put some bar lines in, you can always use the black pen, for example. But I'm going to finish deleting the rest of the second ending here. So I finished erasing the second ending. I'm going to tap Done to save my change. And then what I can do is go through the rest of the score and do the same thing, erasing bars that aren't needed now that I have the duplicated and rearranged pages. And that's also a nice way to handle cuts. For example, if there were cuts in this piece, I could use the Rearrange tool to remove the pages that are entirely unneeded, and then use the annotation tool to erase any bars before or after the part that's cut. And then, once I have all of that done, I can export my annotated version. So, for example, I could email this as an annotated PDF to my pianist, and it would have all of the rearranged parts and the erased bars and the cleaned up version of the score for them to be able to sight read off of, either on their own iPad, or they could print out a copy for themselves. And that's it for the tutorial. Thanks for watching, and check out my YouTube channel for other tutorials on forScore and other topics on music and technology.